lot of background noise here.
It really looked like Trevor was gonna be here, dude.
Yep.
Yeah, dude.
Can't move faster, we move faster, then do faster, then move faster.
If she don't deserve it, I'ma... Alright, Juan, good luck, man.
Alright, guys. In the strawweight division, we've got Mackenzie DERN, the submission specialist, the jiu-jitsu black belt, going up against Alexa Grasso, the Mexican boxer.
And I really think we're in for an exciting fight here, Max.
Yeah, I think styles make fights, and this one could get interesting. DERN, obviously, not exceptional with stand-up, but I don't think that matters as she's moved to PSG, where obviously the kickboxing is going to excel, you'd have to believe.
Right off the bat here, no action. First 15 seconds, really letting each other feel it out.
DERN opens with a leg kick.
Just unable to quite find that range. The unnamed fight team for Juan really being cautious early, knowing that they need to be very careful with Paragon. Mackenzie DERN, under the watchful eye of John Scarmato. Very dangerous. Oh, the knee.
And here's the chops of Paragon, right? Coming out, we're already seeing DERN look like a much more capable striker.
100%. That was a low leg kick for Grasso. Oh, DERN
gets one back. And she lands that left again. Yeah, Grasso, I think, does need to leave the fight with her jab.
Those hands never leave.
If she's gonna have any success against DERN, it's gonna be through the jab. Can't eat those.
Oh, head kick. Yeah, DERN definitely having a little bit more of a length.
Oh wow,
Grasso is down. Grasso has to get in close. You can't play the length. DERN. The overhand just misses.
DERN definitely looking like the baddie with a fatty right now.
100%. Newly single Mackenzie DERN, training at Paragon Sports Team, looking better than ever. Alexa Grasso, no slouch though. Talented fighter in her own right. Playing from range like this, not going to be beneficial for Grasso. Needs to get inside, needs to make this ugly. Well, she's so confident. Letting the jab sing right now, Grasso. Smart. You see all she learned from her background in boxing. Ball and the front kick gets through for Grasso. Nice 1-2 there. Trading body kicks.
Wow, Mackenzie DERN is single. That's crazy news.
Yes, you were unaware of this development.
Yes.
Yeah, I was very much aware of this development, trust and believe. But nonetheless, she might be single IRL, but right now she is doubling down on these body shots.
Yeah, excellent segue. And liking what I'm seeing from DERN here, the stand-up very much improved. And if she's going to be able to partner this type of stand-up with the constant threat of the grapple, it's going to be unique.
She will not be able to get any weight on her front leg, which will make her stationary and be very...
Yeah, I think the one thing you're seeing from DERN right now is she's working all three levels. She's going high with some striking. She's throwing those low leg kicks. She's working it to the body. Grasso peppering with the jab, throwing some low leg kicks, but definitely needs to be a little more diverse with the striking. She can start to turn these singular strikes into
combinations now. She's going to have to find something to follow that big strike that she's landing over. Yeah, DERN's able to just block up high, essentially. What we're seeing. Her accuracy's on point. She's very good. Grasso's going to need to look for a big counter.
100%. That block for DERN right now is looking a little worrisome. These jabs sneaking through. But in these boxing exchanges, it just looks like DERN is getting the more significant of the strikes off.
Good call.
Nice combo from DERN.
Grasso going with the kick to the body, but unable
Grasso
to find
missing
the
on a body kick, eats a leg kick.
Yeah, this is the first time DERN has thrown 90 punches in a fight, I can assure you that.
Well, no feeling out process for her here tonight. She has stayed technical, but really a more aggressive approach than we have seen from her in the past.
And we see her
and it's Grasso shooting the takedown.
Oh my goodness.
Combinations. It's just that there's not a lot of power behind these, Christian, but they are adding up.
They definitely are. A lot of
volume. Oh, it's just constant striking. John is taking Dern's striking to a new level, for sure.
That you have to have more output if you're Grasso.
It's like a 3-1. Strike ratio you've got to think right now, if not more.
Yeah, this is really, really bad for Grasso right now. If you're her corner, if she somehow makes it out of this first round, going to round two, you gotta believe that's going to be something that they're going to harp on in the corner there. Oh, and they're just trading in a phone booth right now.
Yeah, and right there we got a glimpse at their head health. Pretty even. Again, DERN landing the bigger shots, got the knockdown. It was already a DERN round then, and then afterwards landing what felt like hundreds of shots since that knockdown. So easily a DERN round. However, health-wise, Grasso standing in there, taking the punishment and landing some shots of her own. Definitely... Yeah, I mean, almost 2-1 everywhere. Yeah. 3-1 significant, plus the knockdown.
I mean, Alexa Grasso, incredibly talented fighter, and that first round was really competitive both ways. A DERN round for sure, but if you're Alexa Grasso, you're not going to win a fight with 9 significant strikes landed. You're going to have to up the volume. You're going to have to put some damage on Mackenzie DERN. You can't play from range. You can't allow her to just pepper you with combos.
Right. Where she left off here. And not really showing any signs of slowing down. I'm going to be curious to see, does this fight hit the mat at some point.
Oh, Grasso's down.
Down again. Another early knockdown here in round two. DERN looking like she has absolutely been working with Charlie Olives.
Ooh, clash of knees there.
Yeah, that looked awkward.
Just missed with the left there. Oh, combination lands for her there. It's Harper with
The uppercut from DERN and Grasso is out.
Well, that was just a gorgeous shot.
Oh my gosh.
The baddie with a fatty starts off the season 1-0.
The single Pringle herself, Mackenzie DERN, with the uppercut from hell. You see her on the replay. Oh, Grasso looking for an overhand right.
Perfect counter. Wow.
What an absolute nasty uppercut from Mackenzie DERN. First fight with PSG, incredibly successful.
Yeah, a lot of success there. We're going to start, obviously, talking to the winner, John, leader of PSG. Mackenzie came out firing on all cylinders. What a great performance. So far, the women's divisions across all the fights have been incredible performances, and Mackenzie, the winner in this one, shows up absolutely with a performance to remember. Was the game plan always to go in there, stand and strike with Alexa Grasso?
Hey Max, thanks for the question. Thanks for the booth work as always. Just big kudos and shout out to Juan and his camp and Alexa Grasso for taking a tough fight here. The plan from the beginning really was, Juan, if you want to, did you already advance to the next screen? You can hit triangle to get into our next one if you want. To answer your question, the game plan was to strike. I think we heard on the telecast that Mackenzie had been training with Charlie Olives, and that was absolutely the case. I don't know if that was a guess, but it was very true. And yeah, we take the same philosophy with Oliveira that we take with DERN, which is we're going to strike with you, and if we need to use the offensive jiu-jitsu, we will. Both fighters have a very similar skill set, with the exception that Mackenzie can't really stand with some formidable opponents on the stand-up. She doesn't have a lot of power, but I think she proved tonight that she has enough to get by.
Absolutely. The volume striking from Dern combined with that offensive jiu-jitsu is going to be a sight to behold. Juan, before we get into this big-time welterweight matchup, did you see what you wanted to out of Grasso tonight? Obviously.